Back to our weather, and let's check in with Anne. Yeah. And we're going up to the mountain.
Yeah, someone's up there. Kind of cool.
Yeah. We saw a snowboarder, I think, in the last hour.
Yeah, we did.
Is that an hour ago? Yeah.
Yeah, so a few people up there night skiing or snowboarding. Temperatures today a little bit warmer up on the mountain than expected. Down at government camp, we were into the 50s, and then right now sitting in the upper 30s, both at the base and at the top there of the mountain. Here in Portland in the lowlands, low 60s today for almost everyone. 62, your official high here at PDX earlier today, almost 10 degrees above the normal for this time of year. Now that the sun has set, though, temperatures falling just a little bit. Still comfortable outside, though, for our Thursday night. We are dry with mostly clear skies. Temperatures here through the metro area into the mid-40s now as we head into the 9 o'clock hour. 49 in Beaverton. We're at 46 in Vancouver and 51 there down towards Happy Valley. So wider view of the satellite picture. We've still had high pressure in control of our weather pattern through the last several days. So that has kept our weather fairly mild and nice with a lot of sunshine. That's going to break down, though, once we hit the afternoon hours on your Friday. This next front will come through tomorrow evening, and that will bring a lot of change here to northwest Oregon and southwest Washington once we hit Saturday and Sunday. So here's what it looks like. Tonight, we keep it clear. Tomorrow morning, I think we start off with some sunshine. Clouds will thicken up, though, once we hit midday and beyond, and then we'll be cloudy through Friday night. But notice the showers that are developing here out along the coastline. I think the showers get here closer towards the Willamette Valley once we are right around 6, 7, 8 o'clock tomorrow evening. That line quickly moves through, and then behind it, it's more scattered activity through the second half of the day tomorrow and tomorrow night. And then by Saturday, we're left with leftover showers here as we head into the first part of the weekend. We could see maybe a few heavier showers, maybe with some small hail or grapple as we go into Saturday afternoon. Otherwise, it's mainly snow up on the mountains here for Saturday, and then we'll dry things out by Saturday evening. A few lingering showers will be left over on our Sunday. So snow forecast here, nothing coming tomorrow. Most of the snow will hit Saturday into Sunday. By Saturday afternoon, we could be up to about 5 inches there at Timberline. And then once we go into Monday, a couple more inches, or Sunday, I should say, a couple more inches there left over into the first part of next week. So bus stop forecast, upper 30s here tomorrow morning. And then once we hit the afternoon, we'll be into the upper 50s with a few showers as the kids are heading home from school tomorrow. Through the metro area tonight, we'll drop back into the upper 30s in most spots, just above freezing in places like Scappoose and Hillsborough tonight. Friday looks like this. We'll end up in the mid-50s by lunchtime, and then we are in the upper 50s by tomorrow afternoon. So maybe a couple of degrees cooler than today, and it won't feel as warm because we won't see as much sunshine. We'll have more clouds moving in for your Friday afternoon. So weekend forecast looks like this. Showers stick around on Saturday. Just a few left over there on Sunday. Timbers kicking off their regular season there Sunday afternoon. Likely going to be fairly dry there. You could be dodging a few sprinkles, but other than that, the weather pattern, it's pretty gloomy for next week. At least lots of clouds, lots of showers, no completely dry days there, and we'll lose a lot of that sunshine for most of next week.